What's going on, guys? I told you we were going to have a special review of something big, and I think this covers it. As you can see, there's a thing right in front of you here, and that thing is in fact a box. Probably the largest box I have for anything at all. And this is, of course, Planet X Apocalypse. Now you're wondering, that looks weird, doesn't it? Yeah, because the rest of it is up there. This is legitimately the largest thing I think I've ever bought. Probably. Like, just so, as you guys know, probably from any of my pictures, Apocalypse comes in two parts. Part A, part B. And yeah, this is going to be a little shaky, guys. I have to hold this. I don't have a tripod remotely big enough to do all this. This is ridiculous. Look how huge these boxes are. You guys have seen, I could barely fit Master Grade size boxes in frame. This is just insane how large this is. Now, just for the sake of doing this, I'm going to go ahead and pull this box down so we can see it. Alright. Now we sort of see it, it's kind of just in the way. Now I'll go ahead and do each box sort of individually and then we'll look at it all together. So, whew, that's a pain. So here you get a great shot here of the chest and head of Apocalypse, which is Planet X's version of the War for Cybertron and Fall of Cybertron Triptychon. And I know that sounds a little confusing. Triptychon was in fact only in, like, technically only in the War for Cybertron game, but he had a little bit of a role in the Fall of Cybertron, which we will get to as we get through this. Now, unlike normal Planet X figures, you don't get just the chest view. You get a whole top half of the body here. And I will go ahead and rotate it this way, sort of, so you can see. It's just a part of him. And we'll rotate to the back side. Now, I don't know what happened. This box in storage over the last week or so has bloated for some reason. The cardboard has just really expanded. Now, unlike other things, you get the Planet X here. Then you get a shot of Triptychon himself doing things, shooting lightning bolts, being all giant and awesome. I'm going to set this over here because you can see, once again, it's two-piece box art. You've sort of already seen this guy. So this is from the crotch area, oddly enough. So the crotch face looks like a snake. No idea why. And then the hips. And then you got the bottom of the torso here. But if you rotate this one, which way does it go? Okay. Huge box, guys. Huge box. There you get the rest of the completed artwork. And that looks so awesome. Not to mention, it really denotes how huge this thing really is. I mean, you see like the torn up and destroyed Cybertronian landscape there. This is just absolutely ridiculous, guys. And I will say, I picked these up from Big Bad Toy Store. Price was good, $179 a piece. But you can buy them together now because they originally didn't come out together. You can buy them together for $354.99 or something like that. So a really good average price. Other places have it probably for a little bit cheaper, but more on shipping. It just depends. I got it from Big Bad Toy Store. A is currently out of stock at a lot of places. And B came out recently, so there's more of it. So if you can find a place that has both, get it. Definitely worth it. But we will we'll get to the actual review of this guy. Now, I will say, this thing is so large, and technically it comes in two pieces, so I'm going to do this review in chunks. I'm going to do the part A, then I'm going to do the part B, and then I'm going to review it all together. So I will include time annotations at the bottom in the description so you can skip around if you need to, because this is going to be a long one, guys. This is a really big Transformer and comes with a lot. So let's go ahead and get to it. Alright, guys. So here's going to be the first part. So this is the foam and everything that comes from inside the part A box. So I'm going to show that off real quick and we'll show how everything comes out of the box when it's brand new. Or at least close enough. So if you open up the nice foam lid here, I gotta do this without making a mess. All right, so you open it up. You guys can see well enough. You get a great big, awesome laser cut cutout that is in the shape of Apocalypse. And you get this little nose piece. Got to take that off before you can pull it out. And he does come with a bunch of LEDs. Now, if I remember correctly, I just kind of put these in here for the show. I think that part A comes with 8 LEDs. Now, that happens as well. I do believe originally they had tape on them,
so that wouldn't happen.
But here's a cool thing. If you order from Big Bad Toy Store, this may be the same for other places as well, you get 3 spares. It'll come in a separate little box, so if you see that and you get a little confused, that's what they are. Because I didn't know when I first unboxed it. If you watched my unboxing video, I did not know. So they come with 3 extras. So this guy comes with those. And the big handful of these awesome little LEDs, the purple ones. Their Genesis had little red or orange ones. And they are little pressure switches, so yay for that. It's going to blind you. That's cool. So these are all awesome. I will definitely show you off what these do when we get there. So that's the box, the packaging, whatever. And here we have Apocalypse. Oh, jeez. Huge guy here. This is how he comes out of the packaging in this really strange spaceship kind of mode. I really wish I had a wide-angle lens. So, out of the box, he comes like this. He's kind of intentionally transformed, I guess, for storage purposes. They couldn't have him in his quote-unquote jet mode or spaceship mode because it would have been too big to fit in the box. So they kind of transformed him to fit the packaging. Now, I will put him in his normal mode in a second. First, we're going to take a look, as always, at the instructions. So, out of the box, you get big old sheet of instructions. And I mean big. These are poster-sized instructions. They're probably the size of a box, realistically. They're a little dinged up, just from the first few days of me learning, and then I had to fold it up, put it back in the packaging. Now it shows, this is how he comes out of the box, and this is how to get him into his little spaceship mode. And then from there, they show you how to get him into his torso mode, and then a quick little tutorial of how to put him into full-on robot mode. And then come to the base of the instructions. If you have part B at this point, it shows you how to get into his final mode, and, well, partially into his, hold on. Yeah, it shows you how to get him into his final mode. So these instructions are actually not bad. There's a, as usual, you gotta kind of intuit a few things. You'll see a lot of obvious parts of the transformation and some things that are not that obvious. See, like this, that goes, that there should be like a in between, like, okay, this is how this goes here. That doesn't even show you how really to do that. And as far as I can tell, they do leave out a tiny bit of instruction. I'll show that. I didn't realize it was a thing until I watched Ben's Collectibles review of this guy. So I'll show off everything that I figured out. So, one other thing. When he comes out of the box, you will have a couple little baggies that will have these spikes in there. You do have to insert them. There are a couple little T-slots, and you just insert them. I was going to try to take them off, but they won't come off once they're in there. So we will go ahead and get this guy into his base spaceship mode. Not to be confused with his base mode, just his base spaceship mode. Okay, so this is probably the least difficult transformation out of the whole thing, like realistically. So just to get him into that mode, first we come back here to the back, kind of flip this up. You got a wing, just kind of flip it this way. Same thing on this one. And you rotate this whole section like so, and like so. Then you take your finger, pull out the center thruster. It just slides in and out, no big deal. Ah, jeez. Okay, so you come under here, you take this part, you see this big old tab right there, and goes into a slot right there. I gotta adjust my light just a little bit now. Make life a little easier. There we go. So if you got a nice hinge here, and you just slide that right up into there, and hopefully if everybody's lined up properly, should go right in. So now that will solidify the front and back to each other. Now there is a main problem, and we'll talk about it here in a second. It's just I don't want to say it's a QC issue, it's just an oddball design, kind of with what they had to do, and it causes some issues. Now, you do have to be careful, because this whole section, this is rotations, and this is rotation. They both rotate, so you got to make sure you got everything lined up nice and square, and then everybody will play along a lot nicer. You can see this gets a little scraped up. Where are we at now? Okay, flipping back over. Now, this whole section right here, this is like, I guess, vertical thrusters, kind of. You take that, it has a big old double hinge, and that would be the problem we're going to talk about there. Rotate this to where these kind of open facing vents are facing backwards, and it will peg in that slot right there. Now, you'll see there's going to be a lot of fumbling around with this. Okay, so just so in case you didn't see it, here's a slot that it all is going to fall back into, and you'll feel it when it gets there. Come on, get there. There it goes. And just kind of slaps in there. So that is his individual little spaceship mode for the part A. See if I can get the whole thing in the shot here. This is a problem. Oh, that's sorry, I forgot. You gotta rotate these up like that from underneath. I forgot that. Sorry, guys. Now, there's a big old snout just kind of looking at you like that. Can you see it all yet? Jeez. This thing's huge. Like, my review space was not made for anything this big. Alright, so now that we've got the part A in his spaceship mode, you can look at some of the details here. So you can get a nice close up here, so you get some cool piping right here painted in a kind of a cool gunmetal color, and get some more details right back here in the same thing, and you will see these nice orange I did the same thing with Starscream. That's purple metallic, you know, indicating dark energon kind of flowing through the guy. You'll see that kind of everywhere as we go along. So you come back here to these little spikies, nice and purple metallic, just like the ones that were on the back. Kind of moving up a little bit here. Nice metallic purple on the wings. See right in there in that little joint, you get some nice clear lucent purple plastic. It's kind of nice. Rotate them up. Once again, that's going to do its thing. You see some nice purple stripes through here. No kind of details here. And here you got a little bit of a visible head syndrome, more or less. Tuck that back in. We're going to have to do that like 19 more times today, guys. Now, I love the fact this guy is not black. You guys can kind of see he's actually like a very dark purple. Like a very, he's not a bright purple. He's very, very super dark. In different lighting, he will look pretty much black. But this thing is so, so cool. I love this. Kind of see some details here. You can see a little bit of gray, inside there. And these do move around a little bit. That's mostly due to transformation. We'll take a look at that later. Thrusters are very nicely molded. You can see that right through there. All three of them very nice. And inside, you can see some clear purple plastic. And we'll talk about that here in a minute when we get into other details. And if you come to the side, this is the same on both sides. You can see right here inside these pods are some missile launchers. That's pretty cool. That kind of stays in pretty much every mode. And it's just like that. Now, if we actually look at the this kind of side thruster detail here, you can see inside, you can see the same texture detail. It's the same clearlucent plastic that's back here, or transparent or translucent, whatever you do. And you get some nice purple metallic paint right there for whatever those details technically are. Of course, the other major detail of this guy is the big orange clear plastic here, and of course back here. Now, there's a detail, we'll talk about it, the way this looks later on as to why I think it looks that way. I think it has something to do with the way the game functions. But we'll get to that when we get to full robot mode. Sorry guys, my sinuses are still bothering me. But I love the fact, right in here, you still get great molded detail all along here. And that does have that nice kind of gunmetal silver going on. It's just really nice. Now, one big problem I have with this is how loose these are. Look at this. This is not this loose out of the box. So you get a couple spring-loaded tabs right here, and then this thing itself, sorry, is a spring-loaded rotation joint right there. So you can spin it, you can stretch it, you can flip it up, down, sideways, whatever, and you can see it has that little spring right through there. They get super loose and they'll pop out, especially when you're doing transformation from like robot mode. And you see it's not quite fitting in there very well. Not to mention it's just super floppy. I've had this thing only about a month or so, and it got that loose that quickly. It's not that big a deal in most of the modes, but when it has to be down like this, which I believe is for its final mode, then that's when it gets a little floppy. You can see I just took it out real easy. I'm gonna see if turning it around will help, because that does turn. Now I don't know. Looks like either side. No, that really didn't make a difference. It doesn't really tab in. Okay, speaking of not tabbing in, this. So this is the main flip-flop joint, transformation joint for quite a lot of it. In robot mode, this is his backpack. You got a hinge, you've got rotation joints, but the way they tab in is right here. These two circular tabs go into those holes right there. Now, those holes also tab in to these right here. So whenever you kind of accordion that down, it will tab in front and back. And it takes little to no effort. Now, I guess that's okay because realistically, it would just be too hard to make, to make that a little bit tighter, it would probably, become a problem. You'd never be able to transform it, but it is what it is, guys. Now, if we come down here to the bottom, you can see what will be his robot mode chest. You get some great molded detail right there. You can see those purple wires and/or pipes. Sorry, it's focusing on my arm. There we go. And we get some more gunmetal coloring in there. Let me flip this up and see if it helps. Okay, there we go. And you can see, like, I think. Like it almost looks like certain parts are almost different colors. Maybe that's just because this is a slightly different plastic. I'm not sure. There's a lot going on. There's a lot of clear plastic on the chest, and we'll talk about that when we get to that part. But I will show off what the LEDs can do in jet mode. So we come back to the back. You have your LED right here. You can see inside here you've got a tab at the top and the bottom, and you have slots. Top and bottom there. So make sure you push it with the button going in. You stick it in and you rotate it so that it will hold in place very nicely, like so. So you get those two thrusters. You can do the main thruster right there, though it's probably easier to do it when it's inserted all the way and then pull it back out. Although you lose the inner ridge to help pull it out. So that's really awesome. That's just in these pods or these thruster pods. Now give me a second here. We're gonna set this guy down so I can maneuver this. If you take the missile pods right here, you can actually pop these open. Like I said, you can see same translucent plastic there, and you can insert these on either side as well so that his extra thrusters or VTOL thrusters, whatever they are also lit up, and that looks really awesome, like very menacing. I really like that. You just rotate that back down and just kind of punch it back in the spot there. We'll do the same thing on this side real quick. Now, this thing does come with 8 LEDs, but realistically, regardless which mode you have them in, you're only gonna use 7 because the one that goes in the final spot is pointless for jet mode because that goes in the center of his chest. So that's, like I said, that's just pointless. Okay, so for all of his thrusters, you get that. That is beautiful, guys. That is so awesome. And I love the fact, this is a really expensive toy. Like, I mean, it's $180 by itself. The fact that it comes with these awesome LEDs is great. And, the fact that you can leave them in there for the most part for almost any mode does add to it. Now, of course, whenever you go to robot mode, the thruster here, the main thruster, totally pointless because you won't see it. That gets buried. So there's no reason to have that one on. Of course, now I can't get it out. So we'll pull that out. I'll leave the other ones in there and we will get him into his robot half. Let's try to get him into his upper torso mode. Now, first and foremost, we want to come up here to the front. We want to take these, rotate them up like so on both sides. Now, this is one of the modes where it's pretty much tight, so that's not going to be an issue. Okay, so we flip it up like this. Wait, is that right? No. Yeah, open that up. Now we push up through the bottom, and you'll see that this upper part wants to come out. It tabs in up front, and then the whole part will flip-flop forward like that. Now we could take this part, rotate it out, come back up here, take the nose, and flip it inside like that, and shut the big old door. And then we come back here, and we close that back. Now it's got a couple tabs here, here, and then it clips in up front like that. So that's that part. And it's basically just going to be in the way forever. Now for the most part, we're going to do a lot of the work facing this way. So when you come up here, untab these guys, like so. Where should I work next? Yeah, I got to think about how the way the instructions tell you versus the way you should probably do it. So turn him this way. Now what I'll do is I'll go ahead and get the hands in hand mode. So you flip this guy up, reach under here, pull out his thumb, I guess, technically speaking. And then do it on both sides. Just go ahead and get it done. Come on, get out of there. Now you do have to, when you transform him back, you need to make sure that the thumb is curled under like that, or else you won't get it pretty much where it needs to go. Like I said, there's going to be a lot of flipping and flopping with this guy. And he's so big and so heavy that it's going to get really old really fast. Let me figure out. Okay, so the wings, you know, you can rotate them and everything. You've got the same kind of spring-loaded joints here in the middle. You want to pull that up, flip it over like so, and flip that side down like that. Now, whether or not that's facing the right direction at the moment, we'll leave it be. We'll figure it out, because that kind of can get in its own way if we're not careful. So we'll take this, flip it around, take it out from under there. It will sort of just loosely tab into place just to hold. Now this is one of the more annoying parts. So you have to get the finger out from under there, but it gets hung up on everything. Like one finger is now holding the other finger in place. Okay, so now we pull that out and we stick that back there. And you see that tab right there will just tab right in there. It's a loose fit, but it does what it does. Zoom back out just a little bit. Okay, so we want to do the same thing. This side, you got a lot more clearance. There's way more to work with. And then we just shut it like so. And then we take both halves of the hand. You've got a big tab right there, if you can see it. It will go into a slot right on top of the thruster right there. Here, just barely, you know, tab in. Now you've got these big old tabs that will go right into there in those little slots. Now if you got the thumb lined up properly, it will do it easily. It's usually not that big of a pain, but just make sure those are tabbed in very, very nicely. All right, I went ahead and did the other one off camera just to save a little bit of time. Now we're gonna go back to this kind of vertical position here. So much flip-flopping, guys. Now you can see right here, you got these little bridge pieces that are connecting to the center thruster area. What we need to do is pull that apart like so. Now when it's brand new in the box, that will be nearly impossible to remove. I swear, almost impossible to pull out. I had to really, really force it. Now you take this guy, tab it back down like that. Come over here, do the same thing. And guys, I will warn you, like I did with all the other Planet X figures we've looked at so far, there are lots of pointy things on here, and you will also smash your fingers quite a bit transforming this guy. Now you see, I just did a wiggle technique just to kind of get that loose, and it does work that way. Now, you will hear, this guy has insanely heavy ratchets. And that's a good thing for as big as this character is. So, we'll rotate this. Like so. So you got the shoulder joint here and the you know, rotation for the shoulder joint right there. Get him down like so. Rotate that down like that just to get it out of the way. And you can start seeing where we're going with this. Now, this is one of the other hard parts. You got to grab the chest right here, grab the whole thing, and pop it forward. Sometimes it fights. Other times it's perfectly normal. This time it's wanting to fight me. I don't know why. Now, if you don't have one of these Lego prying tools like this, get one. Because it's incredibly invaluable, especially on this figure. I've used it more on this than I have actually on any Lego set so far. So you just kind of get under there and pry things out. I don't know why he's fighting me. He's never fought me like this for this part of the transformation anyways. Come on. There it goes. Okay. Whew. Yeah, seriously, that was harder than it normally is. So you can pull that out, and you can see right in here, you got some really big, heavy posts that attaches to. Now what we're going to do, take our handy-dandy pry tool again, and come right in here, right in there, and you got to knock this off the big mushroom pegs, like so. You can see these ridges right inside there. The mushroom pegs will plug into that. So at this point, you're going to have a big floppy mess. You're going to have arms and backpacks just going wherever they want to go. But now that that's loose, the chest can now move forward quite a bit more. And what you do at this point is take the whole upper section up here, this whole thrusters. Ah, jeez. And you got to rotate it downward. Now, here's a big clearance problem, guys. You have to make sure that this is pulled forward enough or this will drag right across that front, right through here. So, I mean, you have to untab these to get enough room to move this. So, you do that, and it will scrape a little bit, but it is what it is, guys. That's just the way it works. At this point, you want to rotate the head out of the way, or else you can't do anything else. Take the whole shoulder joint, you pull the thing up on the double hinge. Oops, it's still tabbed in down there. Like so. And put the mushroom pegs back where they belong. So that brings all the shoulders up. And now you take the chest and you bring that all the way up, tab it back in. And now you can take the backpack, fold it up on itself, and you'll see you got posts here and holes here that will line up with everything back here. And actually, if you line it up right, this will become a very, very sturdy backpack. Just like that. Now we come down to the arms, rotate below the elbow, like so. The whole hand came apart in the middle of all that. Come on, get your hands together. And just for the sake of everything, let's go ahead and bend him at the elbow, which is incredibly, incredibly heavy ratchet joints, and you got to be careful with that because you can break something if you're not careful. So once again, you hold the elbow joint, rotate below that, I guess you want to call that the wrist, and we'll bend at the elbows and get him more or less in this form. If you do a little bit of finagling, you can get him in a point where he will sit. Oh, I totally forgot about this. These spikies on the shoulders, go ahead and float them down. Rotate these forward. Sorry, I just knocked the camera. Tuck these down. And there we have him in his upper torso mode. And yeah, that was a lot of work just for that. But I'm going to take a picture real quick. Did you see that? Nope. Okay, good. Now, in this mode, you can, of course, see a lot more detail, guys. You can move the fingers around a little bit. So you've got some heavy joints here, everywhere. And I said, you got the really heavy elbow joints. But like I said, you can get a lot of rotation out of this up here and then down here. So you can turn the hand however you need to, and then you can turn the arm however you need to. Now, the biggest problem with this is, of course, the way the wings tuck away underneath the arms. You just really have to fight them all the time. They're just always going to be in the way. There's just no good way to do it. I kind of wish you could just unpeg the guys and just slap them back on. A little bit of parts forming would be fine for this, I think. All right, let's take a close look at some of the details. You can check out the chest here. It just looks awesome. You get what looks to be like some big vents. Of course, all the clear plastic on here. It's just wonderful, amazing molded detail, as usual from Planet X. Let me get this arm kind of out of the way here so we can see. Now, a lot of the things you saw in flight mode become pretty cool now. So that's now his rib design and everything like that. I really dig that. Super heavy ratchet joints really do come in handy. I like that. Let's look at the head sculpt because we haven't checked that out just yet. So yeah, he's definitely his big kind of dinosaur head mode. And I like the fact that right now with the light, it does have some decent light piping there. So you can see his eyes go away. Now, I do wish they put an LED in the head for that. That would have been awesome. But unfortunately, they didn't. Speaking of the LEDs, you can see you've got the ones in the hands. They're still doing their job. And you can turn those around so you can actually get some cool beam effects. Not entirely certain. Like I said, if you had the one in the thruster, it would be entirely pointless now because the thruster is now facing downward into this area. It wouldn't be lighting anything, I don't think. I doubt you would see any of it. But yeah. Oh, I always forget about this. Inside the mouth, you do get a really cool little cannon right there. I think he usually shoots fire or something like that. That's pretty awesome. And then on the side of the head, in the jaws, you do get these cool purple joint covers. You get a little bit of that gunmetal silver right there on those little details. Gotta love that, guys. Now, this is the detail I totally forgot that he had, or actually, I'm sorry, didn't even know because the instructions don't tell you. This little part you can see totally has a hinge right there. But when you first get it, it's going to be insanely hard to pull up, and you're going to be scared you're going to break it. Trust me. Trust me. So you can pull this up. It'll be really scary, but once you get past that first little notch, you can come in here. And you can replicate sort of the G1 Triptychon look with the cannon that comes out of his head. Now, mind you, that thing is really hard to get. You got to get a fingernail kind of there somewhere to pull it out. Now, the actual cover there does get in the way, so if it's not coming out, just pull the cover back a little bit. That's as far back as it'll go. You can't push any further, but you do get a nice cannon. It's very similar to the one that's in his mouth, but now you can kind of pose it and stuff like that. It looks awesome. I like that. I think it's more for like base mode, maybe, or I don't know. Because I think in base mode, yeah, you can use it in base mode because his head, we'll see, his head is kind of flat like this. So you could totally use that cannon in base mode. But that's very G1-esque, and I love that. That's just so cool. And then you just kind of double hinge it away like so. Ow. Once again, pointiness. These teeth on this guy, very pointy. Now, they were pointier on Snarl, but these are definitely pointy. And these little chin spikes, also very pointy. And since we're on the head, let's talk head articulation. It's actually pretty neat. So you've got a rotation joint right here, but cut on a 45-degree angle. That's how you can get transformation. But you can also rotate the head right there at the base of the neck. So you can totally get him looking over each of his own shoulders like that. And, I mean, Triptychon is a great character from the game. Now, mind you, I didn't play War for Cybertron, but I've seen the videos of the gameplay. And I'll say now, because we're going to get to scale here in a little bit with the rest of the figures that we have so far. He does not scale at all with the other figures from Planet X because he's a city transformer. He's city size. In the game, he started out as a weapons platform, an orbital weapons platform that was enormous that the aerial bots are flying around in. This is not that. This would have to be like the size of my apartment complex here for it to work, and I can't afford that. So, but I'm talking about the chest. We can do that right now. And I know some people were confused when I posted this originally in some of the Transformers groups. They did not know how to get this in here. And once again, no instruction of how to put any of the LEDs in. You just got to figure it out. So you just kind of grip it by where the Decepticon symbol will go eventually when Repro Labels gets that far. And you just flip the door open. You take your LED, cram it in the chest, and do the thing. Come on. Doesn't want to rotate. There it goes. Okay. So now you got that. And also, while we got that open, you can see he's got some cool details right there. So shut that, and now that's awesome. So whenever we do get a sticker right there, it'll be clear, and it'll actually look like the Decepticon emblem is lighting up. That is really cool. But for the moment, hold on. I want to turn off some lights here so you can see how cool and how bright those really are. So that effect is just beautiful. Like that. So that's also why I wish he maybe even had one in his mouth or something like that, get that mouth to light up, which the mouth has some nice molded details inside, but you know, in this mode, you know, you get what you get. So this is his upper torso. So this is as far as you can get with the Apocalypse Part A. And I know that seems ridiculous, right? So that's only what the first bit will get you. So now I can get this guy out of here, and we will talk about the Part B. Alright. So, here we have the Part B and the foam that it came in. Now, within the box, we do get the instructions. Now, why these are a completely different dimension than the other instructions, I don't know. I guess because the other one only had 4 rows, and this one has 5 rows of instructions, I guess. And you do get your storage mode, you get your combined mode, you get your getting it into other modes. Once again, the instructions are a little iffy, but odds are for a couple of these things, I'm going to need to refer to this. So, keep them handy. And also, with the Part B, you get the character card. So yay, you get the repeat of the box art here, but of course they don't have enough room for the tail. Yay for that. Let me see here. Okay, it's spelled right. But we come to the back, and we look at his stats. His strength is maxed out. Well, he's a city, that makes sense. Intelligence is a 3, I think it should be a little higher. Speed, yeah, he's ginormous, it's not going to be huge. Endurance, yep, pretty good. Rank, middle, yep. Courage, yep. Fire Blast, of course. And his little bitty skill is pretty good at 7. So yay for cards, and of course because he's Decepticon, mostly purple, yay for that. But it's dumb that you have to get the B before you get the character card. I would have sent it with the A, but that's just me. I don't work for Planet X, so of course you come here and you take off the foam top. Now the difference between this one and the Part A, I could fit this one back in the foam so you can see kind of how he comes in storage mode. There we go. Whew. So, that's the Part B in the box, in the foam, whatever you want to say. And it does come with 3 more LEDs. Now, once again, with this one, ordered it through Big Bad Toy Store. And once again, could be the same for other retailers. This is just my experience right now. You do get a separate box with 3 more little LEDs. So, that means you get 6 total. So, one way or the other, you get an extra 6. Now, you could just use these for if your original ones die, they're going to stay for a long time. But if you just leave them running on display, they're going to run out of power eventually. And from what I can tell, you can't open them up, at least easily, to replace the batteries. I mean, let's see here. Pull one of these guys out. Yeah, I mean, I can't see unless you can get a screw driver in there to like twist it open. I honestly don't know how you could replace the batteries in these. So the fact that you get extras is a good thing. I mean, more or less, like I said, these could be for Omega Supreme or Genesis whenever he gets infected with the Dark Energon in War for Cybertron. So it's kind of dumb. You actually have to kill Omega Supreme in the game. Now, hopefully, sometime later this year, I can get that Omega Supreme, that Planet X Genesis, so that I can actually compare these two, you know, enormous titans from Transformers. So, that's it for these. Let's go ahead and get him out of the box. So, we'll just grab that big hunk of foam right there. I'm going to grab these LEDs while I'm sitting here and thinking about it. Stay. Now, you can see he's kind of crammed in there. Now, this is as good as I could do to get him back in the box. I think it's pretty much how he was. You can see his tail is just kind of curled up here, and his feet and arms are just kind of crammed in as best they could be. The toes were the hard part. That I couldn't figure out how they went, so I just kind of curled them under to see if that worked. I think it is how it goes. Now, if we start back here at the tail, it might be the easiest, and then grab by the head and just pull him out of the foam. and then somehow get the foam out of here without knocking everything over. So this is the lump you get out of the box. So if you want to get him into his own, I guess you want to call it spaceship mode, so to speak. Ow. Pointy. Immediate warning of pointiness with these toes. They're very, very pointy. So we want to straighten that out. Do the same thing on the other side. Straighten out these toes without stabbing yourself repeatedly in the fingers. Too late for that. Flop that down. We're going to take this on more heavier ratchets. Rotate that way. And just kind of point it forward like so. Now, the heavy ratchets are really good. Don't get me wrong. But sometimes out of the box, they are super heavy. All right, so now you have him in what I guess they want to call his kind of spaceship mode. Or the Part B's spaceship mode. I don't know. That's kind of it. I call it like the flying snake mode. I would say it goes like this. If I had to guess, this is the front where the big tail is. There's no real information on that other than, hey, this is a thing it can do. Now, you can see already, this thing is ridiculously long. Whenever we get full spaceship mode later on, which is not a whole lot bigger than this, 24 inches long. I haven't thought about it. I should measure this to see how long it is in this. Hold on, guys. Handy-dandy measuring tape. So I'm going to go from the tip of the tail to as close as I can approximate. Oh, wow. Okay, so in this mode, he's 27 inches long, guys. That's over 2 feet. That's also why I can't fit it entirely in the screen here. Well, I guess I could. I just have to change the way I video it. But let's go ahead and get him ready for robot mode. There's not anything else you can really set this up for, just robot mode. So we'll go ahead and do that. So we take the leg, rotate it. Essentially 90 degrees, take the toes, front and rear, and just kind of flatten them out. We'll adjust the legs later on once he's totally together. Ow. Once again, pointy. The big pointy things. Now with the legs, that's where you're going to end up pinching yourself a lot. So you can see right through. Actually, you can't see. But right up in here, that's a really tight, tight area there. So we'll flatten out the feet. Ow. As best we can. I'm going to say ow quite a bit in this review, guys. Just get used to it. Okay, so now we take the tail, take it from this really heavy ratchet joint down here, and point it essentially down like that. You can go a little bit further if you want, but I'm going to leave it like that. So the tail is essentially like this. First of all, details on here are ridiculous. I'm going to look at it now because once he's fully combined, he's going to be really hard to move around. So we can see here, great molded detail all along that tail. Look at these panel lines. This is ridiculous. All these great big points coming down here. And each one of these segments is individually articulated. So you can totally get this amazing curve here. Even the tail, hold on, the tip down here is articulated in of itself. These are just frictions. Everything else is ratchets. So you get these nice ratchet joints all the way down. You get the purple here for all of this. That's just so awesome. So you can really kind of pose the tail a little bit however you like. Now, there's no side-to-side waggly movement, but that's okay. You don't really need that in your giant Transformers. Now, we can play around with the legs a little bit here. Say I want to rotate it forward just a little on that hinge. We'll bend at the knee just a little bit like that. So rotate up, bend at the knee. Now, let's see. That's just cool. You get so much molded detail, so much more purple in this. So all of these leg spikes that are dangerous are very nicely purpled. Actually, right between here and here, the molded purple is different than the painted purple. So you get a little bit of that glow. Repo labels, when you get to this guy, if you get to this guy, lots and lots of Energon glow. I don't care, $20 kit or $20 sticker kit for this. Do it. It needs to happen. Let me get a little bit closer here, rotate up, and you can see what looks to be the crotch face. I don't know why he's got like a snake as a crotch face here. I'm guessing in G1 he had to have had something very similar to that. But that is what that is. It's just a crotch face. Definitely is a snake. You get the fangs here. You get what looks to be like a tongue, sort of right there. Does have totally clear plastic right through there, and some nice purple paint right through there. All along here, nice purple details in here, like almost like hydraulics, like tons of hydraulic pistons right there. And much like the arms, you do get rotation right here, but nothing below the knee joint. With the foot, you can get a kink like that for the ankle, so you can actually get a really wide stance form if you really want to. Really want to plant those feet like that, which I might have to do just to film everything. I might need just those like half inch variables in and out of there. Of course, the knees have some really, really good articulation there. We've already seen that the toes can articulate. You actually get a toe joint here in the middle, like you get that middle knuckle for the toe joint, so he can actually like grip onto things. That's insane. And then you come back here to the heel. I don't believe that little guy is articulated. I don't think so. No, it's not. Okay, so that's not articulated, but you do get the heel spur that can move. I don't know if it's really necessary with feet this big, but you totally get that heel spur. All right, and before we go a whole lot further, hold on, I want to do the tail one more click that way. Okay, so now that the crotch is facing a little bit forward, now this is where the three LEDs he came with come into play. You see right here, a very familiar spot. Now, why they chose these joints, I don't understand. Because you've got these places right here that would have been awesome. Same thing with the joints here would have been awesome. And no, there's no way to add an LED into that ratchet joint. I've looked. So you could take it, plug that in right through here, rotate. So now you've got that spot. We'll do the same thing on the other side. Oh, and another thing. This is heavier than the part A. I'm not joking. There's so much weight right here in this center section. Like, I don't have a scale that'll work, but between the joints right here for the tail and just the middle part, they made it sturdy. This thing has to weigh a good couple pounds just in and of itself. Now, just like you can do with the chest, grab the face on the crotch, pull it open and down. Sorry, that bottom part was messed up. And there's your other LED hole. Now, the only thing that sucks is there's so much going on with this, even though it is all clear on the backside here, and it's got to go through two layers of plastic. So this right here actually kind of hurts it. You'll see that even with this LED in here, it's not bright. Like you can't even tell that that's on here. Look, you can't really even see that those eyes are glowing, but they are. I mean, they're just barely glowing with a faint purple glow there. Now, how about I just kill the camera? Now, maybe if this was a little thinner, or maybe if we made a hole right there so the light could penetrate through just a little bit better, maybe that would work. I don't know. But, it's kind of sad that it's a really cool gimmick, but you can't even see it because it's just too thick. There's just not enough. So, but I think that with the way the light piping works, if I were to cut that, it probably wouldn't be too happy. I don't know. Maybe. We'll see. I might do that. I might make just a take a just a drill a hole right there so the LED can come through, and we'll see what happens. Maybe even add some reflective tape to the backside so that the light can penetrate through. But for the time being, we're gonna go ahead and close that up. Now, this little part down here underneath slides forward and back. That's mostly for transformation purposes, and we'll take a look at that later. But let's see if we can get them into combine mode. First, you take these two tabs, you flip those open. And you guys can tell already, I'm not going to have enough room to actually do this. So, what I'm probably going to do is set the camera up on a stool or a box or something to get a much higher perspective for most of this review. But for right now, we're going to go ahead and put this guy together and we'll take a look at it. So, on top right here, you've got four holes and two clips right here. And they will correspond to the pegs and the big mushroom pegs right there. So what we do, take that, and this is actually good at least to show off how the transformation works, combination works at least. We gotta get the arms out of the way because they do interfere with the legs slightly. So you get that on there, get everybody lined up, and a little clip. Now you take these two tabs that were on the side, they will go right in there for two other small poles, posts, whatever. And now here's a cool thing that you could not tell until you got them into combine mode. He totally has a waist click like that. Let's see, push him back just a little bit. And that's about as good as we're gonna get. Like, you cannot see all of him at once, but this thing is absolutely beautiful. And I'm gonna be honest, this is the first time I've had him in real light. This is so good looking. I'm gonna take a picture real quick because that's just sexy. Oh man. So here we have Triptychon finally in his full robot mode. And like I said, we're gonna have to probably get something so I can get everything in one frame, and I'll probably be working from a distance to work on this guy. He's so unbelievably heavy and cumbersome in this combined full-on mode that the rest of the transformations are going to be difficult. I will tell you that right now. But I'm going to take a break for the moment and go eat some lunch, and then when I come back, we'll finish this guy. All right? I know this video's already gotten long, but that's why time annotations at the bottom. But this thing is so awesome, guys. I'll be back in a minute. All right, guys. So I've got to zoom out quite a bit here, so you're going to see a little bit more of my review desk. But that's the only way I can get everybody into the shot here with this big old guy. When I get to transformation, I'll have to figure out something else. But for right now, we're going to get into some comparison so you can see just how big this guy really is. So, there's Wally. Wally, this is Triptychon. He's ridiculously big. You don't really want to be his friend, but he's a big guy. So, that's how big Wally is in comparison. I mean, it's just microscopic. And if we're going with Planet X figures, as I stated way back at the beginning of this review, I'm knocking stuff over. So they can't technically scale with it, but there's Prime. So Prime is roughly half his size, comes right up to crotch level. Everything else is here. Now mind you, he's hunched over too. I did measure, but I'm gonna go ahead and measure again right now. So up the back to the tip of the points here is roughly 15 inches when he's standing about as straight as he can. That's huge, guys. Like, that is just absolutely ridiculous. Okay, just for comparison, we'll add in the MG Gundam. I just finished reviewing this Monday. So Gundam Sandrock is not even up to the level of his legs. Mind you, of course, wing Gundam kits are shorter than standard MGs. Let's see, what else can I compare him to? Alright, for real world comparison, there's a Fanta bottle. So, a 20 ounce bottle is about yay tall. And I just realized I left all the lights on. I gotta take those out before I finish the review. They're probably gonna get a little dim. So, that's that. And for one other comparison, something big I've reviewed already, there's the Ninja Legacy Ninja Megazord, which, you know, isn't that much taller than Prime. But that's your scale, guys. That's just it. So, little bitty Wally. Got some Prime going on here. And that's how big Apocalypse is. And for somebody who was asking for this for comparison's sake, wanted to see this, I'm going to take this picture. There we go. Alright, so that's gonna be that. Now I gotta reposition everything again. Alright, guys, I figured I'd get a fun shot for a nice transition there. Alright, let's see. I can zoom back out. So, that's Trypticon here, holding the actual Hasbro version of Fall of Cybertron Prime. Now, mind you, this is still not to scale, but it's a really fun dynamic shot. And just to show you that this guy really can pose. Now, I sort of talked about it, but he has the waist articulation in the middle, so he can actually do ab crunch, but he also has waist rotation, so that actually allows you to get some movement out of him. Now, mind you, these stupid legs are like interfering with the arms. And it's, I really hate that about the wings that hang on there. So that, yeah. So that's your scale there for how this little deluxe guy scales. Now, once again, not even remotely the right size for Trypticon, but it is what it is. So here we can get a nice shot of Prime there. Now I did sort of try to set things up so I might have a little bit of room to film here. However, it might still be a mess for transformation. Now you will notice I've taken out all the LEDs because I didn't want them to go dead on me. Plus, they're not really needed for the rest of this. I don't know which mode I'm going to go to first because we got two really big modes to go for here. I think I'll take them to base mode. So that's not going to be easy as well. Let's see here. Okay, so we're gonna kind of take him into, we're gonna partially transform him into his original jet mode. So it's kind of the basis is how he gets to his jet. So let's see what we can do here. So we want to straighten out the head a little bit. Go ahead and straighten out the body. Get that. Straighten out the legs. Basically make him tall. Rawr. Me am Trypticon. Oh, I did want to show him off with the Dinobots. I forgot. Oh well. Okay, so first things first. We gotta rip him apart. Kind of. I'm gonna go ahead and straighten out the arms. Now, when you're doing these elbow joints, push on something solid, don't grip here, because if you're gripping up here by the hands, you could end up snapping them at the hinges, and you don't want to break your very expensive toy. So, kind of grab and push like that. Now, if I remember correctly, we're not going to need the hands, so we may as well tuck those away. So, fold the finger in, fold the whole thing in. Once again, these are the biggest pain. So, straighten out the fingers, they're pretty good there. Rotate, tuck that away, tuck that away. Come over here, try to do the same thing. Hopefully, you guys can see all this. I'm not watching the camera, I'm watching what I'm doing. So, hopefully, that is remotely how that's supposed to be until we get to the rest of the mode. Okay, so we got both hands done. Now, we want to come over here, pop the chest again. So, you want to loosen that up. You want to pop the back loose. Remember, it's got all those tabs tabbed in now. There we go. Relinquish that. Okay, so we want to open up the top like we did before. And we want to open that. So we swing the nose out, swing that back in. Go ahead and close that. And instead of closing that over it, we're gonna leave it like so. Got it? Got it. Now, just like we were gonna transform it back into flight mode, like I said, you wanna turn the head back around. It's easier said than done sometimes because of all the things around it. Okay, so flip that down. Why is the head not? There it goes. Okay. So you gotta kind of make sure everything's rotated the right way, or else it gets really wonky for some reason. Like it won't go straight. There we go. Okay. So, okay. Oh. So now we take arm parts and we want to split those as usual. I think. Pretty sure this is how it goes. Put that down. Ow. Scrape myself. Reattach. Like so. Put these back down. Oh yeah, these shoulder bits are in the way. And we want to close the chest. Straighten the head. Okay, now it wants us to just kind of have the arms out more or less like that off to the side. Make your lives easy. Then we come around to the back and we want to flip. That's all right. Okay. So we take all this, tab it back in, right in there. For some reason, it does not want to cooperate today. Come on. There we go. Why is that not? Alright guys, I don't know, somehow in just finagling with it, I got it to go correctly. So now you can see what's happening up here. So now you got the head facing that way. I don't know, it was not cooperating. I have no idea what the heck happened. Okay, so now what we want to do is come down here and rotate the whole thing. Oop. At the waist, just spin them around so that he's facing his tail now. This is the hard part. This is where you really start shifting everything around. Ow. And then that happens. So what you want to do is come down here and pretty much just straighten out the tail as best you can. Does he have one more click down here? I think he does. Okay, so that's as good as that's going to get. Alright, now, I'm going to take the whole guy and lay him down. Such as this. Oh, jeez. Like, I'm not joking. This is just a lot of moving stuff around, guys. Okay, where do these guys go? Do you believe we make these go vertical as such? Tuck the claw in like that, and then rotate the leg. Come on. Like so. Here, let me rotate the whole thing for you so you can see what I'm working with here. Yeah. Okay, this is the base mode, and it's annoying. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and skip that step. There we go. Much better. I guess the problem was I had the knee bent on this side. Let me straighten that out. There we go. Now that's the way it should be. Okay. So now you've got a big face-planting dinosaur sort of object here. These need to be straightened out. Okay. Okay. A step that I totally forgot about. You gotta come all the way down here to the crotch. You're gonna grab the snake head. Push that as far back as possible, I believe. How does that work? Hold on. No, I said push this down. Flip that around. Okay, so now you got the face head, snake head. Doing that number. Wow, my entire review set is jacked up at this point. Push those forward, I guess. Man. Okay. So, now on top of that, something I should have said to do earlier, you take these and you tuck them under. Like so. Did I stress this wasn't easy? And moving and reviewing this guy and transforming it all at the same time on camera is very difficult. There we go. Oh, jeez. Can we even see what's happening anymore? Alright, so we want to bend the arms a little bit at the joint there. Go ahead and pull this out. Kind of like we had before. this point, we're going to go ahead and flip up this missile pod. We're going to do the same thing on this side. Come here. Like that. Something like this. Like this and like that and that. Okay. What a mess. And then I do believe we take the arms. And then, man, that's a lot. Okay. So we take the arms and we bend them up at the elbows so that the thruster is facing that way. But this needs to be turned around. That needs to be dropped down a little bit. And we need to take the wings, unfold them, and rotate them so they're sort of like that. It's all a mess, guys. It's a huge mess. So I don't like this mode. This is probably the worst mode out of all of them. Okay, so like that. And none of this tabs in any way. In no, at least in a meaningful way. Nothing tabs in. Okay. Here we have Trypticon, or Apocalypse, in his ridiculous kind of base mode. Now, I know that this is, at least in some ways, reminiscent of his original base mode, but very much not. Oh, and I forgot about this. So, I mentioned this in the robot mode. May as well see if I can pull it out now, if in any way, shape, or form, and get this cannon out. Come on. There we go. Okay, so now in his base mode. Ugh. This is ridiculous. Now hold on, I'm gonna shift the camera down so we can look up at this. Okay. So we've got the big snout, we've got the dinosaur head, spikies, arms over here. Big old missile pods and a cannon right there. Now, I know I've seen somebody did this as a throne, like they put Fall of Cybertron Megatron on it as a throne. I don't believe that's what it's meant to be. I think it is just supposed to harken back to the original base mode. Now, I don't believe that he has a battle station mode like he did in the game, where, you know, he's a big orbital cannon, more or less. So this is probably just as close as we're going to get to anything like that. And this is a huge pain. You guys saw most of what happened there, but there's a whole lot of figuring it out. I mean, I like the detail of the big spiny tail kind of coming up like this, although that is, at least in my opinion, very reminiscent of Scorponok in his base mode. But for that, you would have to kind of like this. So, I mean, to me, that looks fairly intimidating. I mean, the big tall tower, that's pretty cool. But I like this with the tail curved over. And you got cannons. I mean, you can't even really make out everything that's going on this guy because it's just that ridiculous. I mean, yeah. And come in close here without ruining a shot. So you've got the cannons or the thrusters that are right here. If you had the LEDs lit up, I'm sure that would look pretty cool. The feet there just supposed to be like outcroppings or plateaus, something like that. I mean, you want to curl up the toes, make it look even more like a wicked tower, and do something like that. And you got the great big missile pods. It's a little dusty. That's actually cool. I mean, it's one of the first times you really get to see the missile pod sort of doing its thing. And you get Trypticon's head right in here with the cannon coming out. Now in this mode, you can sort of see what I was wanting to get to. There's striking similarities between this part and Trypticon's head, and I do believe that is on purpose, and I believe it's for the final part, which is going to be the Nemesis. Okay, guys, I'm going to shortcut this a little bit. I went ahead and got him pretty much back into robot mode, but I left the arms in the jet mode because that's what we're going to need anyways. No reason to go all the way back for no reason. Okay, so what we do, if we got to get the upper torso pretty much back into his jet mode. So if we can unplug the top here, if it'll unplug. Okay, go ahead and unplug the back. Spin the head around. And then try to flip the whole thing without breaking everybody. It's gonna break everybody. And that's what I thought. Okay, come on. Stay there. Okay, one thing you never want to do is pull on these little shoulder pieces. They're just flimsy little plastic there. Okay, so I need just a little bit more room to finagle things. There we go. So we want to rotate that back and get the thruster out. Like so. Tab these back together. Now mind you, these are in the lower level like we had them before from base mode. Okay, so now we've got the thruster coming out the top. We want to flip these up. I'm gonna rotate the arms, which is easier said than done with all this mess going on. Okay. And I'm just reversing basically everything we started out with. Come on. Those really super heavy spring-loaded joints. One problem is the torso keeps flipping on me because of the legs and the tail. Okay, just hold yourself up for a minute, dude. Jeez. Okay. Now we gotta pull out. You're not gonna be able to see this, but the pegs that go into here, you gotta make sure you pull those out. And like I said, probably not gonna be able to see this. Oh good, you can. There's the peg. Now we want the arm totally straight. Line the pegs back in and tab them in. So like I said, we're going back essentially to flight mode. Go ahead and pull this around. Now these guys are tucked in right under there. If you can't get it out, that's the shortcut. Okay. Oh good, I have these facing the right way. Loosen that. I was having a little bit of a problem with getting everything lined up and back the way it should be. Okay. I'll tab that in. Okay, so now that hand is crooked. I gotta fix it. There we go. Okay. So, now what I did, at least I don't think it says to do this in the actual instructions, I go ahead, just to add stability, go ahead and tab those in, just like we did before. Come on, get in there. There we go. Go ahead and pull out the thruster, just because. Now for Nemesis mode, you have the wings facing this way. Before, you had them this way. So, Nemesis, not Nemesis. Nemesis, got it. All right, and this one, we're gonna go ahead and pull these down here, just like they were before. So we're kind of in between his normal jet mode and his storage mode. There, now that's all squared up nicely. You guys probably can't see. Okay, so you need kind of a weird totem pole thing going. This is the death of me. The hard part is I'm working at full extension here, like just arms fully out, and this thing is very heavy. Okay, so next comes the hard part. We have to get all of this back end transformed properly. Now, by the way, this is kind of just dangling back here, which makes it very annoying, and there's no tabs, so I have to now work around it. All right, so I'll just do that. Face plant. Okay, so now what you're gonna do, you have to move the legs. The legs also can ratchet forward just a little bit. You can see that. So you want to ratchet the legs. So it's kind of like this. I don't know, this is a really, really unfortunate angle, but it is what it is. Why are the legs not? Oh, okay. This one's not straight. There we go. Okay. So now we're going to split the tail like a lobster. Kind of. Come on. There we go. You got to start at the top and work your way down. And the giant tail is all tabbed together. Okay, so we're going to fully split the tail open. Now, mind you, I'll take a second to go ahead and check out this detail. Look at all the molded detail on the inside. Now, they didn't paint anything. It's just molded in that nice gray metallic plastic. So, I think they missed an opportunity to make something really cool there, and they just didn't do it. Okay, so now here on the crotch section, remember I mentioned this part slides. So you want to slide that all the way back. And now we want to take the weird crotch face, flip it over here, and up and around. Whoa, he's knocking the camera. I think that is correct. It's either that way or the other way. Let me look. Okay, so I guess... Oh, okay, I see what it was saying. You want to take it, rotate it down here, and then take it back like that, I think. I think this is what you're supposed to do. Now he's some kind of weird flying demon creature. I've only done it to Nemesis mode once, guys. I'm just going to admit that. Yeah, that's what we want. We want this face down and flat. Oh, jeez. And of course, now it says rotate the whole thing. So, we want to turn it. Oh my god. Really? Sorry, I got to do a lot of this off camera. Turn it like so. Okay. This is the not easy part, guys. Okay. So we want the thing back here. Now, what you want to do with the tail is kind of curve it up like so. Hold on. I got it in the wrong spot now. We want to rotate. There we go. There we go. That's what you want. That was not easy. Not to mention the fact that this tail is way over here. Okay, so you gotta do a lot of finagling with this tail and the other bits. Not joking, guys, this is hard. Okay. Well, we'll do all the final work here in a minute. Okay, so we want the hands, our feet rather, to be totally flat. Like so. Now, if I'm correct, what I screwed this part up in the shifting of things. Now what we want to do is rotate all of this like so. Oh wait, no. Okay. This way. Okay, so the end result, what we want is the leg to be facing that way. Hey, it's not easy, guys. It really isn't. Okay, so I'm going to see if I can show what I did. I had to really mess with it. Now I have these giant tentacle spikes here to deal with. Okay, now... Alright, now did everybody catch that? So, you want it to be more or less like this. Now, mind you, it's still kind of a mess around the midsection. It's all gonna straighten out here at the end. Come on, there we go. There you go, big boy. Big boy. Me, big boy. Okay. I swear it's worth it in the end, right? Okay, so we want to take the front section, the front middle rear section, and flip that forward like so. Now before we go too far, you need to come under here, and I don't know why I didn't say to do this earlier. You gotta open this door, so you can open this door, and you can't see anything I'm doing. So you open both doors so you can flip out the final nose extension, and then close all that back up like so. And tuck that like that. Okay, now we want this laid down flat. Now what we want to do is take the arms, or legs rather. There's some big old pull tabs right there, and there's a hole right around there. Now what we want to do is get it into that hole somehow. Except that the knee is bent. There we go. Okay, so like that. So you can see right back there, that hole pegged into, I guess what was the backpack before, or where the backpack was. Jeez. And I feel I forgot to do a thing, and I did, so it's gonna be impossible to do it now. Okay, so hold on, before we go too much further. Okay, now on the back of here, camera's a non-light. So right back here, there are these tabs that flip up like that. See it? Maybe, yes, no, those. Okay. Now those have to peg in underneath here. Now, I didn't mention it before, but these things right here are spring-loaded for this purpose, to clear the legs, the knees, like so. Now the tab will go right underneath this knee claw right there. And if you get it, like I just did, that now has solidified most of that all the way across the board. Now I gotta do the same thing, but over there. Okay, so you go flat, more or less. Turn that down just a little. Let's see if I can get that peg to peg in. Of course, I probably have the knee bent. Yep. Hand up. Knee bend. There we go. Now that's tabbed in, like so. Ah, jeez. Okay, now the hard part is getting that final tab right there into place, because you have to reach up underneath to get it. And believe me, getting it back is the hard part. Pause for a second. Okay, it took a lot, but I finally got that tab in there. Now, whenever you get to the tail parts, which are now like the forward forks, you kind of want this alignment. You want this one bent, and then these all straight. So they run pretty much parallel with the nose. So you can see on the other side, I've got them kind of curved. Now they are straight. And if you knock it down just a notch, like so, you kind of get that forward arrangement. I'm gonna set it down. That also helps it sit more level on the ground. Now there's still one more little thing to help solidify this whole thing. So we've got our old friends, the missile pods, right here. So you want to push them all the way forward like that. Now this has a nice big old hinge that you can pull it up on. You can see right there, there's a tab or post hidden kind of inside there. You need to pull it out, and it's going to go right there. One of these holes, it's going to go in there somewhere. So you just take it and tab in somehow. There we go. All right, and now we've got that. Jeez. This is only for one mode, guys. Only for one mode. And this is the heavy mode, as I call it, because it seems to be the hardest one to maneuver around. And we'll come over to this side, do the same thing. Go ahead and pull that post out in the middle of the hinge. and tab it in. Now the reason that other side has more holes is because that's actually the screw hole side of that leg. Now the instructions want you to point it downward, like a thrust, like the hover thrusters. I like to leave it backwards facing. Now you can also open up. Ah, jeez, tail moved. Okay, you can also do this one right here, and it just folds down, kind of just revealing a little bit of detail work. It honestly serves no purpose other than that, as far as I know. In the instructions, I don't even think it tells you to do that. Now, at this point, you can open the spikies just a little bit, like so. Am I zoomed out all the way? Yes. All right, guys. So this monstrosity that I can't even completely get on camera. This is the Nemesis mode. Now, he was defeated at near the end, his final boss, I believe, of War for Cybertron. In Fall for Cybertron, they used what was left of his body to create the Nemesis to go after the Ark as it was leaving. So you see in the actual game, his head is like right there, sticking up out of the ground, and then starts transforming. The big long nose comes out of it. Everything else changes. So I do believe that this right here is supposed to replicate his head, because you can see the teeth sort of right there. Something it's always been a detail, but it was there. But more or less, this is actually Trypticon's head, and that's why it looks so similar to his actual head when you see it. So, you know, they do a little bit of trickery with this, obviously. But I love the fact that Planet X even gave us this mode at all. Like, I mean, they could have just given us the giant robot dinosaur mode, and that probably would have been enough for most people. But to include his only contribution to the Fall of Cybertron game by making the Nemesis happen is awesome. Now, this thing is not very reminiscent of the G1 Nemesis. It's more... Oh, it wasn't Prime. There was another... It's one of the other ones, but it's very similar to a different version of the... Actually, no, it is very reminiscent of the Nemesis from Transformers Prime. I forgot about that. They did create the Nemesis, and that was awesome. But that had nothing to do with Trypticon. But one thing you always got to remember, you got to extend the nose cone. I know I've seen a couple, at least the only other reviewer I've seen that did this guy, he forgot to do that. And, you know, it's just a minor detail, guys. But nitpicking is nitpicking. Just like I got to nitpick all these little things. So many small things have to come together in the right order for this guy to be perfect. And it is ridiculous. I mean, not seeing any really new details here, but I like the fact that you get the big purple spikes right here. They used to be on the knees. You get this one here. All these little... almost like turbines, kind of all over, that you would think maybe would help him fly. It's just cool. And of course you can put a good bit of the LEDs in here, but like the ones that would go in the chest, so they're just going to be pointless. You can get the ones here, you can get the ones in the thrusters, and you can get the ones here in the back of the pods. But you know, that's pretty much it. Actually, you can kind of angle that up just a little bit like that. That's kind of cool. I like that. And this is the mode that is hardest to maneuver him, because he's so big. Now, I did measure it, and this is 24 inches from the tip to the back. So this is shorter, oddly enough, than the Part B on its own in its spaceship mode. Now, this is probably the largest thing I'm ever going to review, maybe, that I can even think of. It's absolutely ridiculous. Now, I did just do the Thunder Megazord, and that's big, but not compared to the original Thunder Megazord, which I'll be doing that comparison in that video sometime soon. But this is just absolutely ridiculous here. Let's see here. And I like the fact he looks very insectoid. He looks like a giant Insecticon, at least in my opinion. That's what he looks like. I'm gonna tilt the camera just a little bit so we can see everything that's going on. Alright, guys. Almost done. But we gotta do at least one more comparison, and that is to the only other flyer we have from this line and from this third-party creator. Here we have Starscream in his jet mode, so you can get a sense of scale for how big this guy is. And they show in some of the promo images with the new Seekers coming out, they show them just sitting on him. Like, so Starscream there, Thundercracker, and Skywarp on each side comparatively. But that's gonna be it. And this is definitely the longest and biggest review I have done to date. Here's Wally. All right, so that's gonna be it, guys, for this Planet X Apocalypse Part A and Part B collectively here. If you really, really love giant Transformers, and I mean, if you really love them, go out and get this. All the major retailers online have it. Big Bad Toy Store is where I got it. I'll put the link down below. Like I said, all that long time ago. You may not be able to get Part A at the moment. I think it might be on back order, but there's plenty of places that you can order both together. So just go out there, search Planet X Apocalypse Part A, Part B, and you will find it. This thing is awesome. Honestly, for everything you get with the LEDs, for how huge this thing is, for the sheer amount of plastic, I think it's a good price. It is, it's not cheap by any means, but it is a good price and a good product. Now I just need to get their Planet X Genesis so I can have a comparison to this guy. And here's hoping that someday in the future they do a Metroplex from Fall of Cybertron. Not, there's plenty of companies that do Metroplex. Even Hasbro has their actual Metroplex, which is based off of that version. So, it would scale fairly nicely with this. But that's gonna be it, guys. So check out all my other Planet X reviews. There's still one more I have in my possession I have not looked at yet. It is another Dinobot. And I can't wait to get to that. Thank you for sticking all the way through this video. If you did, if you skipped around, I don't blame you. But as always, remember, keep on nerding.